Hi everyone, this is Dina here at Madison Reed. Thank you for joining into our Facebook Live today with another edition of our series called Colorist on Call. So we're basically helping you all out in this quarantine situation. So we're here and we're there for you. So today our topic, I think you can take a guess. It's about coloring stubborn gray hair, and that's something I know a lot about since I've been gray the last 30 years. So I was about 15, 16, so you can do the math there. And it's something I kind of dabbled with, like trial and error, learning what works the best. I'm also a professional hairdresser here in San Francisco. So I'm experienced with all hair types as well. So basically, what we're gonna do is demonstrate for you how to do it all, especially if you're very new at coloring your gray hair, maybe you've never done it before. This is a really good video if you don't have any experience. And also, just to let you know, gray hair is stubborn because the texture actually changes. So let's say you're salt and pepper. That pepper is a little bit more pliable. It accepts color easier than the hair that is gray. So I'm really excited to show you how to do your hair color. I consider myself kind of like a ninja for hair color. So I hope that you're gonna feel confident as much as I am. And it is quite easy once you know the steps. So what we're gonna do is first section the hair. What that does, it just gives you some control so you don't feel overwhelmed of coloring all your hair. So this is one of my favorite combs from Madison Reed. It's a nice little pick there. So I'm gonna take off my glasses to do this. So this is a clip provided by Madison Reed. It's sold separately from your kit, but you know, you can have whatever kind of clip you have at home is fine. If your hair is shorter or finer, you know, maybe something small like that. Also, I recommend maybe coloring your hair when it's not extremely dirty, because sometimes when you have a lot of dirt, oil, or product in your hair, that can cause a barrier for the hair color to penetrate. So, for example, myself, I did wash my hair yesterday morning, and now it's the next day evening, so what, day and a half or so, and I was mindful not to put any styling products on my root area, and I was very, I don't even think I conditioned my roots, mostly on the ends, knowing my hair is stubborn and I really want to make sure I get those guys. So you don't want to maybe deep condition or do an oil treatment or that kind of stuff before you do this. Okay. This is the sectioning. Also, when you receive your kit, you're gonna have instructions in there. If you lose your instructions, don't worry. We do have it on the website at madison-reed.com. If you're like me, I don't like paper. So basically in your kit, which looks like this, super cute, everything's organized. You're gonna have your instructions in there. So what I'm doing today is option B. So when you open it up, it just depends what your goals are. So I'm going with option B. So always read the instructions. You know, I'm a professional. Anytime I use a new product, I religiously just focus on the directions. I might even make my own little notes on there to make sure I understand it in like quick bullet points. Sometimes when you're applying your color, you can forget and go, oh wait, did I do that, you know, the right way or wrong way? So just kind of takes all the extra words out. So basically, option B, we're only doing the roots. I'm happy with the color on my ends. They're lighter. It's an old highlight that I feel kind of looks like a balayage. So I'm going to just do the roots, because what can happen if you do color your hair all the way through, what's gonna happen is this is gonna be all one color, dark. And you don't wanna build up color because you don't want the bottom of your hair to look darker than the top of your hair. So it's very important. If you have gray roots, just do the roots. So today I'm using my favorite color, Modena Brown. It's a level 5 hair color. It's like a nice natural brown. And sometimes as it fades, I might put, you know, a gloss, a color reviving gloss on my ends, just depending what color I'm craving, you know. So there's a few nice shades out there for brunettes. So today we're gonna do a bottle application, but I will also kind of give you a preview on a brush and bowl, okay? So you don't have to measure anything. It's already pre-mixed for you. So basically it's the color, and that's the activator solution or processing solution. It's 20 volume. So that's standard for root gray coverage. So you twist this open. Okay, and then here's your tube of color. You twist it like that, like toothpaste basically. And it's sealed. And then right here, you just puncture that. Okay. And then you're gonna squeeze. Easy, easy. Okay, and then some people's skin is porous, so what's included in the kit, it's a barrier cream. So I have makeup on, it's the end of the day, I know my natural oils are there, I shouldn't have a problem, but especially if you have an event or photos to take, you know, the next day after you color your hair, it's really good to do this. Okay, so. Just want to protect my skin. And I like to feather it just to kind of mimic a natural hairline. Take my glasses off. You can do the ears. Usually people know if they're porous. I mean, their skin is porous, so. You can get the neck, especially if you have long hair, it might lay up, you know, on your skin. So there's that. And you get your. So now I'm ready. I'm gonna put my gloves on. Right now I'm wearing a shirt that doesn't really, you know, I don't care about this shirt. So if you, you know, you want to be mindful, wear a shirt you don't care about, a button-down shirt or a smock to protect your clothing, especially when before you go in the shower. Let me just fix this. You don't want to stain, you know, a brand new shirt or a white shirt. Okay, so now the color is in the bottle, you know. I'm going to just give it a good shake. The directions say 20 seconds, so I guess just depending how strong you are. Also, you can see the components mixing smoothly like cake batter. You don't want it chunky. You want to make sure it's, I like to mix very well. Okay, sometimes I like to just look in there. Still looks like I could mix a little bit better. I'm not that strong. Good shave. And I can kind of feel it. Like at first it was a bit clumpy, and now I can, if that makes sense, I can feel the smoothness. Okay, so here's a bottle. Be mindful that there is a cap right here. I've seen some people, you know, attempt their color and they're like, nothing's working. And I'm like, oh, your cap is on. So make sure you take that little cap off. You want to start where you're more resistant. It's usually the front, or, you know, like myself, I started graying here and then it slowly expanded over time. So I know I'm very resistant in this area. So, and also I wear my hair this way. So I will go ahead. And I'm dabbing gently, okay? If you rub it too hard, you know, as I say, try to get it in there real good. Sometimes what you're doing is you're actually wiping it off the gray, and then it's going over here. We want to try our best not to get the color where it's already colored, because color on color, it kind of goes darker and darker. So I just kind of dab it. I want to keep it right where I see the gray is. Okay, then I like to kind of do the hairline. Okay. So I'm oozing gently. I can always apply more if I want to, but you want to be careful if it's your first time not to squeeze so hard and then too much color comes out, and you know. So now I'm going to section. Okay. Also, what I did to prep my hair, it's kind of wavy, and then when I sleep it's really messy in the morning. So I just kind of went through it very quickly with a flat iron. It just makes the hair easier to move. If the hair's too dirty or you have hairspray in it, it could be kind of difficult to section. So I'm gonna just focus on this section. I'm not worrying and being overwhelmed with my whole head, right? So we're gonna come here. And I'm dabbing on my scalp. I know it's there. Okay, and then I'm gonna do a thin section. See how I can kind of see through it? If you take too much hair, you could miss some spots. So, and also when you fully saturate the part, it's thick enough, so it can kind of protect you in that situation and saturate the underneath side for you, okay? That's why we wear our shirts we don't care about, right? So I give it a good shake and I slowly ooze it. Give it a good shake to get the air pockets out so I get that smooth distribution here. Again, pat, pat, pat. Whatever if you're used to coloring your hair, whatever makes you feel comfortable, you can stick with that. A lot of us, we do things differently and then we still get the same result. So there's, could not wait to do my color today. Okay, I wanna just focus here. Again, I'm dabbing. You don't wanna really wipe, because like I said, it's gonna push the color off the gray area. That's where we want it to stay. We don't need to worry about where it's already colored. Again, I kinda shake it down and then I go. sometimes what you can do, some it depends on your hair texture, what you feel comfortable with. You can section with the comb. Come up like that. And also, I don't want to squeeze too much color because you don't want to run out of hair color. Sometimes, if it's your first time ordering, you can order extra, like a second bottle, just to make sure. And then if you don't need it, you can save it for another root touch-up, but you never want to run out of product. So that's why I start light. And then when I make sure everything is saturated, I'll go back and reapply. And just make sure, you know, I didn't miss anything. So I'm using this to section. And as you can see, I'm not concerned with being so fast. Because it's in the bottle, once it reaches my hair, it'll oxidize. Don't worry about that, I can just do that. I'm not worried if I missed anything because, like I said, you're gonna go back and check. Okay, so here you are, you finished one section. So I just kind of gently go through the section I already colored. I can see the color. Sometimes people put too light, and like I said, they wipe it too much. You actually can't even see the color. So that's a good sign that you can actually see it. If you're just tuning in, we are focusing on covering stubborn gray hair. We want to fully saturate the roots the best time I think to color your hair is like the day after you wash it. Not too many days or too much products in your hair. The cleaner the better. But, you know, not the day you shampoo it. Because you do want some natural oils from your scalp. If you have really thick or curly hair, you know, and you might feel overwhelmed, you have too much hair, it's okay to just get a clip and clip it out of your way, okay? Don't worry about doing exactly, you know, the way you see it done. When I do that, the color come out easier. Finish. We're halfway there. So when you're sectioning, it's kind of like what I do, I envision. Like I'm turning pages of a book. So just kind of keeps it systematic. And when you're used to doing your hair a certain way, you just get more professional versus like doing it differently every time. You kind of just get programmed in. And then, so I just kind of wanted to demonstrate a bowl and a brush. That's my preferred method. I like to use, you know, this to really get like nice thin partings. Just to kind of demo that for you. Okay. So you get, you know, a decent amount of color on there, and you're just gonna go like that. And then the sectioning. You know, we're not gonna pull the color through. We don't wanna over darken this. And you don't wanna rub too hard. Like let's say you're putting your color, it's like dab, like that. So when you brush too much, this is what's happening. The color is going where you're already color treated and then there's not enough color at the root, you know? So be mindful of that. Now, the challenging part is the back of your head, for all of us. But you don't always need a three-way mirror. You just can feel the product. So I like to go straight down, okay? Then let me just demonstrate the sectioning before I do the application. You can see, right, here's my part. You're gonna apply, hold this. And I can feel where's my previous section I come down. You can feel kind of how much hair you have, you know? You can feel it's like a thin section. And then keep doing that. Okay. So that is with the brush. gonna go ahead and do the bottle. I think most home users like the bottle. If you're clumsy like me and drop things and knock things over, a bottle is better. Okay, so because I had the color sitting on the counter, it's down like that. You wanna bring it back down a little bit. So just a tap. It's not really gonna come out until you squeeze. Might be too thick. I'm gonna go make it thinner. I'm not worried right now to make it so perfect because I'm gonna go through and second coat it, like painting a wall. I'm not worried of having perfect sections. I just know my section is thin, not too much hair. And then the previous section is kind of holding my hair in place from the good saturation. Feels good. So since my first section is complete, I just share the clip. It just feels less overwhelming. I think it feels easier just concentrate one section at a time. So there, and I know this is done, and now I just have my other section. There's also cleansing wipes inside to remove any staining. Sometimes I like to kind of clean my skin while I work. I will divide this in half. It's a big piece. Okay, so I might just do a little piece because the color didn't really oxidize yet. You know, any comb is fine. I just like this one. Just kind of get things organized. Don't worry so much about being fast. It's all about the application and saturation. For stubborn gray hair, make sure you have a generous amount at the root area. We don't want a color where it's already colored. If you have leftover color, use it for touching up where you already worked. Maybe if I was tired, you know, like if we were getting into fall winter, I tend to like everything rich. So you would do that in the last 5 minutes, but I'm enjoying my lighter ends. What happens when you do your color just for the last 5 minutes? It's really like pulling it through and then like, okay, let me get ready to wash my hair now. Because the last 5 minutes, I don't know, for me it's like quick. So you might think it's 5 minutes, but it's really, it's been 10 minutes and you don't want that to happen. Because I'm a professional, I'm really perfect with timing. So sometimes like if the client's due to be shampooed by 45 minutes, I'll actually start walking them to the bowl at 40 minutes. By the time, you know, they get off their phone, grab their purse, I warm up the water, I make them comfortable in the chair, you know what I'm saying? That's gonna take some time. So be mindful that if it's on for 5 minutes and then you get up to warm up the shower or grab a towel or undress to get in the shower, that 5 minutes is probably now 8 or 9 minutes and you don't want that to happen. Also, you only want to do that, I wouldn't even, like, I color my hair maybe every 3 weeks. So if I were someone that wanted to richen up my ends, look at it. It's not a rule by your calendar, it's the mirror. Like, hey, I like my hair color, so I'm not gonna pull it through. But maybe after a few weeks, I'm like, oh, that color that was nice and rich, it's gone and I feel dull. Then I will go for the 5 minutes. So, you know, if you like your hair, leave it alone. If you're like, oh, I don't like this light hair, I want it all one color, then you can do it 5 minutes through the ends. Because the hair is porous, it's gonna grab faster, where this is very resistant, it needs all that time, you know, 45 minutes to do the job. That is honestly the number one hair color correction, I think, in a salon. I colored my hair, you know, why is this, you know, light brown and this is black? So you don't want to turn into an expensive correction. Also, the color crew here at Madison Reed, they're all professional, licensed hairdressers. They know what they're talking about. They're very supportive. They'll walk you through it. And you can feel the product. It's a little bit cold, so I can feel it on my warm scalp. And I just dab. So if your grays are not resistant, or your hair grabs dark really fast, stick with the normal processing time, which is 35 minutes. But if your hair is resistant like mine, 45 minutes is what we recommend. Again, you don't want to color everything because it's gonna go darker than the root. And even if you did want it to go darker, it's not a good idea to do all of the hair for 45 minutes. You can start at the root, and then if you wanna go darker, talk to your color crew colorist, email us, and just send a picture of your hair. And then we can kind of see, you know, the porosity of the hair. So if, like, I got these highlights a year ago and I barely blow dry my hair. So it's not that porous, but if you have highlights and you've darkened it, then you've highlighted and you heat style every day, you curl, you know, every weekend, that hair is gonna be more porous. And what that means, it grabs color fast. But get your gray hair needs the full time. So, you know, if you want a quick refresh, occasional 5 minutes every other root touch up when needed. But if you do want to go darker, you know, you can go more than 5 minutes. And do baby steps. Like, you know, maybe you don't know the porosity of your hair, or you've never colored your hair yourself. You don't know how the product works. You don't know your hair's porosity. You know, baby steps. We even do that in the salon. I don't know this customer. I don't know how her hair will react. What I'm gonna do is start with something comfortable. And then based on the results, I'll say, oh, okay, maybe next time we'll go a little darker, or I'll leave it on longer. Or it looks good when she leaves, but when she comes back, I get the feedback, okay? So based on that feedback, it's just like cooking in your kitchen. Oh, I put too much salt. Next time I know I'm not gonna put this much salt. So keep that in mind. Don't just go for it and say, oh, it'll be fine, you know. Baby steps. So if it didn't go dark enough, if you wanted that 5 minute refresh, you know, the next time you color, go for 7, go for 8, you know. So, this is gonna sit for 45 minutes. And I just want you to notice that, you know, when I did apply the color, I wasn't in a hurry. I took thin sections and I do have some leftover color. So, you know, if you want, double check. Most of us, of course, where it shows, like if you miss a spot in the back, it's not that big of a deal, right? So I'm just gonna not waste my color and make sure I get those first seen grays. there you go. Also, we are going to have this Saturday another series of our Colors on Call. And I believe it's going to be the same time, 5 o'clock. So as you can see, I left all my previous hair color out. I'm just covering the gray. I like the lightness at the bottom because when I curl my hair, I kind of like to see that dimension. That's it. So it was such a pleasure to be here with you guys. Please give us a call, email, make a comment. Let us know how we can help you. And it's that easy, honestly. So again, 45 minutes is key. Leaving this out because we're already happy with the color, we want to match it. Anyways, thank you so much for tuning in. See you next time.